Oh, Muhammad Ali's white satin boxing trunks from his epic Thrilla in Manila fight with Joe Frazier up for auction. Sotheby's estimates a value of between $4 to $6 million when the historic piece of sport memorabilia hits the auction block on April 12. That's next week, Friday. The October 1975 bout in the Philippines marked the end of one of the greatest trilogies in boxing history. In what proved to be a punishing encounter, Ali retained the heavyweight crown when Frazier's trainer barred him from answering the bell for the 15th round. The Philippines' top economist calling for calm. Amid the country's ballooning debt, NEDA Secretary Arsenio Balisacan says debt is still under control even after Philippine liabilities breached the 15 trillion peso mark in February due to larger local borrowings and high interest rates. He is also confident that government would be able to bring this debt down before the president steps down from office in 2028.
We are actually very in a very good position. The rule of thumb for emerging economies is 70% of GDP is debt, and that's a threshold. No, we are moving from 60%, it's way below 60, to even lower, no, of 55, almost about 56% by the time we end the term of the current president. So. We are not only way below the threshold, but we are also we still also would want to decrease that further.
Balisacan's remark, though unable to soothe the nerves of at least one Philippine senator, Sherwin Gachalian says the country's debt is already alarming. He adds it may be so high that the grandchildren of today's youth would still be paying for it.
Nakaka-alarma talaga, no, na lumolobo yung utang. Dahil yung utang na yan, babayaran yan hindi lang tayo, kundi babayaran yan ng mga anak natin, baka apo natin, baka yung anak pa nila. Kaya intergenerational ang utang eh.
Now, here's a look at the local corporate headlines we're watching this morning. We want to start with the earnings numbers from First Philippine Holdings. The consolidated net income grew 19% to 15.1 billion pesos, driven by stronger operating results of the group's power generation and real estate segments. Recurring net income, though, also higher by 8% to 13.8 billion. This despite revenue falling 3% for that period to just 164.9 billion pesos. So what dragged the revenues to slip by about 3%? Mainly due to the slight downturn and the lower pass-through fuel revenues of First Gen. But that was tempered by improved sales and bookings and construction completion under Rockwell Land, the upswing of revenues from industrial leasing and water utilities of First Philippine Industrial Park and commercial leasing segment of Rockwell, and stable earnings from distribution transformers sold and higher sales from the new business products of First Philippine. From FPH, we look at Robinson's Land Corporation, which has authorized the sale of over 1.72 million common shares of its commercial REIT, RCR, at a transaction price of 4 pesos and 92 centavos per share. That's equivalent to nearly 8.5 billion pesos. Proceeds from the block sale will be settled on April 11th, that is next week. And the board of directors, for those who missed this yesterday, listen up. DMCI Holdings shareholders, good news. The board has approved a regular cash dividend of 46 centavos per share and a special dividend of 26 centavos. This translates to a total dividend payout of 9.5 billion pesos, representing about 39% of the company's consolidated core net income in 2023. That's more than the policy that it committed, a dividend payout ratio of at least 25% of the preceding year's core net income. Now, we also have this just in. This is from the Yuchenko-led Petrowind Energy. They've begun yesterday. This is April 4. They started exporting power from Phase 2 expansion of the Nabas Wind Power Project in Aklan. This is, of course, going to benefit the island of Panay, which since the start of this year has been experiencing power shortages. So this is good news for those on the island.